We're disappointed, and there's no positive spin I can put on it.
Can we talk to you real quick?
Another big story we're following for you tonight. State Senator Jane Orey convicted of using her state-funded staff to perform campaign work. We brought you breaking news of the verdict tonight at 6. And news since then, we're hearing from the jury foreman in this case. Channel 11's Alan Jennings has the latest developments.
Don't have anything to say.
No,
you feel like you were railroaded?
We don't have anything to say.
Stunned by the verdict, Jane Orey rushed away from our cameras, refusing to talk about what amounts to the worst day of her life. Once the powerful state Senate majority whip, now reduced to a convicted felon.
I can tell you that we're disappointed, and there's no positive spin I can put on it.
Jane Orey was convicted on 14 of 24 counts, 6 felonies for theft and diversion of services using staffers to work on her campaigns, and 8 misdemeanors for submitting interoffice memos as part of her defense with forged signatures, which included tampering with evidence. The prosecutor denied the case was politically motivated, calling the Jane Orey conviction a great victory for taxpayers.
Gratified that this jury really did its job. They looked at the evidence. They took enough time to really digest what was there. And they came up with a verdict that I think is substantiated by the evidence.
Taking 5 days to reach its verdict, the jury foreman spoke for the group, but asked that we not show his face.
These are not clear-cut issues. None of them were. And that's, I think, a product of how long it took for us to wrestle with this.
Jane Orey must immediately resign her Senate seat. And as of tomorrow, she'll be outfitted with an electronic monitor and be under house arrest until her sentencing on May 21st. At the courthouse, Alan Jennings, Channel 11 News on Fox 53.
All right, Alan, thank you. And the Allegheny County DA, Stephen Zappala Jr., issued a statement about Orey's conviction. Today is a sad day for the residents of Allegheny County and more so for the constituents of the 40th Senatorial District. As for the jurors, he added, it's not easy to sit in judgment of another human being, especially when that individual has held a position of responsibility and leadership in the community.